What an interesting warm-up. Hello, Milky. Julahan. You do. Hi. How you doing? Thank you so much for redeeming the warm-up. We'll start with that. Now let me just switch to the recording screen as well. Do the simple things that I don't do immediately. There we go. Hello, hello, hello. How you doing, Milky? May or may not have gotten obnoxiously excited when I saw you saw my alert. Oh, that actually means that means the world. That's so kind of you. That's so sweet. Oh, that's made my day already. I was hearing like tapping, and it's in the lo-fi. Like, crazy? Is my chair about to collapse? No, it's the lo-fi. All right, so a voodoo Doulahan. Hey, Loki Moni started at midnight, went from her, Zid finished, and then you went live. Sorry, man, what could I do? What could I do? You know, I stream at this time consistently. You gotta just stop finding artists who have irregular time slots, I think. But lovely to see you here, Loki, as well. We're about to draw a voodoo Doulahan. Let me get the right stuff open. So a Doulahan, essentially, I looked it up just before I went, like, I turned my mic on, but it's basically a headless horse. It's a creature of Irish folklore. So, we draw the just basic outline of the man on the horse first, then the horse itself. The term has been stuck in your head, so I thought it'd make you suffer with me. Hey, no, it's a cool idea. Like, it's a cool concept. And let's see if I can do it some justice, because it sounds like what I'm getting in my head is like, to me, it sounds like a really cool idea, so I'm actually super keen to try do something that does it justice, but we'll see. Currently, I'm just drawing a body without a horse. I feel like I needed to get the right shape and stuff before I drew the horse itself. Speaking of Doulahan, I need to make sure Interviews with Monster Girls is on my anime list. Yes, please do. I'm gonna start watching animes like at the end of this week while I do my work and stuff. If you want to get super traditional, the horse doesn't have to have a head either. That's good to know, actually. Hey, Zombie. Lord Mouse, hello to hello, your grace. Hello, hello, hello. One of them is one, and she's my favorite character, well, besides the male teacher and the succubus. Of course. Of course. That all sounds really interesting. I really like, so, one of the things I really enjoy is, I actually really enjoy cryptids. Hydrate? So early. I will do that, though. For you, I will hydrate. Hydrate. Take a sip of more water. Yeah, I mean, I'm a huge fan of cryptids. So any like supernatural or mythological kind of thing is like right up my alley. I actually do like do the horse rearing. That's just fun. I'm going to be reeling from that comment, Milky. That's just so sweet. It was very, very sweet of you to say so. It's going to be thinking about that all the time. You know that, like, meme where it's like, you give a man a compliment? Like, one compliment, he'll think about it forever? That's probably me. At least for the foreseeable future. People know I can draw a horse because I've shown them the donkey I drew for the comic. I can do it. I got this. Hey. Of course, but not just but that's a thing there, but that's okay. So quite far from the rest of it, that's also okay. Bring it together if I have to. Oof, that's weird. Shouldn't bend like that. If I hypothetically random leave, it's because the power went out because it's big as fuck storm where you live. That's totally okay, zombie slayer. Totally okay. Yeah, it's number 21 on your top 25. Nice. That's good to know. Oh, wait, hold on. Sociology show. He wants to study demi-humans and is the teacher in a school with some of them. So it's him studying them and trying to help them and humans understand each other. Helping to understand each other. Very wholesome and I highly recommend it. That's super cool. Yeah, I mean, you've sold it to me. Horses do that, like horses' legs do that thing where it's like backwards. Like that. Now for Twitch support that is currently watching the stream, that is a leg. I swears it. Go give it a tail. Love that I just got like a torso. Torso of a man. Sitting there, that's okay. That'll be filled in later. As time goes on, things get filled in. It's totally okay. Horses kind of have that, like, not weird, but like fascinating, like neck formation where it's kind of like that. And then kind of like, oh, that's weird. Okay. That's okay. It's got very funny shaped horse, but that's okay. Now, when you said that it doesn't necessarily have to have. The horse doesn't necessarily have to have a head. I had my imagination kind of went with that, so I'm thinking instead of not giving it a head, I'm actually going to give it a false head. So basically, like, I'm going to put, like, a blanket over it, or a blanket over its head, or non-head, essentially. Spat on my screen, because I'm a monster. Well, yeah, so basically it's like its head is missing, but they've basically popped a fake one on it. And about the Habaneri of the Iron Fortress, and it's by the studio and the composer who did Attack on Titan. They made it before AOT. Wow, okay. Spit polish. Yeah, it just makes my screen a little bit cleaner. And Moni was saying it's one of her favorites from what we have watched. Oh, that's good. That's a good recommendation, if I've ever heard one. And we gotta give it some of that voodoo, like, quality. So I'm gonna get rid of the actual, like, so this cloth bit gives way to like where the head would be, but we got a little bit of floating, so it almost looks like the horse's head is gone or decapitated even with the hood over it. Then we'll, yeah, have a bit of caving in. That's a terrible mane. Fuck that. Gotta make it good. Gotta make it like a nice mane. For a nice horse. Like, that's more of a donkey's kind of ear, isn't it? Gotta make it slightly smaller. Not quite so big. almost like a dog. That's okay. That is quite horse-like. I say, as if I didn't grow up on a farm. Jobless reincarnation is your favorite one, and you've shown, but that one you need to... that one you need to watch, and not as a background. It has to be... It has some of the most beautiful magic and scenery I've seen in anime. Okay, cool. So I might make, like, two distinct lists. Like, one I can watch in the background... Like, animes I can watch in the background, and then animes I actually need to pay, like, full attention to. Because, yeah, I want to... Because if you say pay attention to these, then I'll have to pay attention to them. Can't just put them on the background. That wouldn't be fair to them. Give it a patch as well, because patches, like, if you do anything like fake and stuff, you add just a patch. It's called Jobless Reincarnation, Steins Gate, need full attention to that one. That's fair. That is fair. It's a naked upper torso. As you do, you know. Hold on, you grew up on a farm? My grandfather owned a farm. So I grew up in and around one. Weird. I did, though. My childhood was spent around various different farms that my relatives owned, lived on. Jankass leg. There we go. I'll make a list of watch in background and watch without distraction tomorrow. Easy as, thanks, man. There you go, that's a little bit closer to the mark. We gotta do some voodoo stuff with it. So my thought process was basically like a voodoo doll. So like doing that like addition with voodoo dolls, but on a grander scale. So instead of pins, it's swords and things like that. That's what I was thinking. I can already tell I'm going to get too into this, like, warm-up, and then be like, oh shit, I haven't done any of the comic, even though I made a promise. Set a deadline, it doesn't matter. We'll reach that deadline, I'm not worried about that. Well, glad you have the warm-up, at least. Yeah, exactly, it's important to warm up, you know? Important to warm up with something. That your art skills are nice and fresh. Not nice and fresh, nice and warmed up. God, what a sausage. I won't draw actual hands. Taking time to do that, that'll be... Won't take too long, but, like, even so. A nice big hilt for his blade, his bladed weapon, because of course he's got to be armed. Not going to stay that long tonight, need to get up early so your mum and you can finish the puzzle we start on Thanksgiving. Oh, that's lovely. Yeah, fair enough, man. Stay as long as you need to, or as long as you'd like. No judgment here. Just happy to have you. That's maybe too big. Fuck it. Fuck it, it's fine. It'll do, it's a cool blade. It can be long as fuck. I'm at 5 out of 15 for the Diablo 4 bosses. Oh, good. That's awesome, I'm glad to hear it. You're making some real good progress. I said I wasn't going to do proper hand. Still not, but like... putting more effort into them than I... wanted to. I initially had planned. Give him a shoulder. And I really like the slouching kind of position for him, because like the idea that he'd slouch and you can kind of assume that his head would be hung low if he had one. I'm kind of into that. I think that's super cool. Maybe give him a nick. How do I feel about the neck? I don't know. Don't know. I kind of like the gaping hole. Yeah, and if people want to give me like, supernatural spooky creatures to draw throughout the month of August or even beyond that, I am more than down. That's awesome. Ah! So many rabbits and sweet little anime faces. Love it. Well, they are headless, they do always carry their head. Yeah, so what I was thinking, I was gonna do a Geralt like monster. So he's gonna have his own head hanging from his horse belt. Horse belt. From his horse. That's what I was thinking. Mouse, would you want links for the Avatar The Last Airbender comics? Maybe. For me personally, I'd feel like I'd want to buy them. Because then I can just have them on my shelf. Part of one of like my, not my whole thing, but like kind of part of an obsessive thing that I have is that I like to collect things. Or they float nearby. Ooh, just have it floating behind, just in a really sinister manner. Kind of into that. That sounds just really almost, well, goofy in a sense, but like still kind of cool. He's gonna have armor there. I don't know why I'm drawing the like hand features. And still no news on the Kickstarter for the art books yet, but I think it will start next month. Do you mean from his horse saddle? Yeah, exactly. You know what I mean. You know what I mean. Be hanging from his own belt, actually. That's my classic belt, like sketch style. As you guys will come to grow sick of is the way I draw belts and stuff. Draw just a little bit of a like, not a cape, but like almost a like a not a skirt. There's a term for it, but it's a waist guard essentially, and it appears on a lot of medieval like armor, and I often put it on most thing, like most pieces of armor will have like this waist guard. Gonna fiddle with the proportions of the leg just a touch. Just to give him kind of that other sinister otherworldliness to him. Touch. Not a big thing, but I do like to just. You'll need stirrups as well, so. That in we cast stirrup, but it'll do. He almost looks like he's like couch potatoing on his horse, which I think is like I find quite funny, but not appropriate for a creature of folklore. But pay the due respect, due diligence. There it is. There's the word. Very me, lol. Yeah, this is how I sit on my, sit like most of the time. Very lazy. To be honest, not necessarily excited to watch Korra, just excited to watch it with someone else who knows more about Avatar The Last Airbender as me. Of course, being you. That's fair. I feel like I will have time on the horizon. I might do it like how, so one of, friend of the stream, Enya Fairy, she usually does like a Thursday night, like movie night. I feel like I could probably set something up on the Discord. And then we could all watch Avatar, not Avatar, Legend of Korra together, which would be kind of fun. Just sit and watch it, even if we don't particularly enjoy it. Something nice to watch as a group. Right, now I need a head. Actually, I might just do some quick doubleting. This is how I make, padding designs. I showed it before, but basically this is how I set up padding. And it's very, this is a very haphazard version, but, get the idea. You get the idea. It's one of my like processes that it's just like eventually it looks like a thing, and that thing is padding, like armor padding. There we go. As opposed to just cross hatching or crosses. Oh yeah, I was gonna put swords through the horse. Hold on, because it's not doing a lot of that voodoo yet. Not yet. But it will do. That's too big of a cross guard. Almost like pin cushion kind of thing with the horse. Hey Creo, how you doing? I can wake you up, but you've got to carry me through Korra like a veteran gamer carrying a noob. I don't want to do that. I still work full time, so I gotta be awake and asleep at certain points. But I'd still be down. How are you, Cryo? How you been? Currently just drawing the warm-up prompt for today, which was a cross between a Dullahan, which, if you don't know, which I'm sure you do know, is a headless horseman, essentially, and and voodoo. So I'm drawing like a pincushion Dullahan. Been better, but not too bad. That's fair enough. I can totally respect that. I mean, I know from personal experience, I know personally it's been a bit of a week for me. It's only like Tuesday. That's okay. Tomorrow will be better. And if it's not, I'll just say it again. Tomorrow. That's all that matters. And I'm actually gonna, even though I've done a ton of design work on the actual body, I'm gonna just put a sword through him. Because he's a pincushion. Just a big ass sword. Right through his chest. Through his chesticles. That's his chest testicle. It's been a little unwell today. I was about to redeem the warm-ups. Oh, well. It's okay. Well, I hope you're on the mend, on the road to recovery at the very least, Cryo. We want to get you back in the gym, lifting those PBs as soon as possible. But you gotta do what you can to heal first. I feel like this should be a tarot card. That'd be cool. Let's suffer together. Yeah. We'll all get sick together. Keep each other going. And I've just had the idea of where the head will be. I just thought of where the head can be. Yeah, just woke up this morning and just feeling horrid. Oh, that's awful. It's always like right at the end of like winter when you just have, you just feel like where the sickness sets in, isn't it? Like, I found that most of my colleagues and stuff are just super sick. And then by 10 a.m. you were fine? Weird. Gonna do it this way, so basically like, cause I've been looking at a lot of knights helmets stuff. Of course I have. I've been working on a long form fantasy comic, so I've been looking at helmets and stuff. So this one's kinda like Shrek's one though, from the first Shrek. Which is totally okay, because it's important to take inspiration from masterpieces, or art, you know. I put a chin strap on it, because that's how the head stayed in. Hate how I've drawn the neck sever, so hold on. Let's do that properly. And let's do a bit of decay on it as well, because he will have been dead for some time. And I've gone for a super simple neck sever design over the other version I had, but I didn't like the tear, you know? I really didn't like the tear of it. The way it like looked. So I like the grim kind of potential that basically this, the pommel on the actual like weapon is his hair that's been wrenched through his helmet and then attached to the sword that's impaled him. And then, you know, like a revenant basically has returned to seek revenge. And the only reason his head hasn't fallen out of his helmet, or his helmet hasn't fallen out of off his head, is because he's got a little chin strap. I feel like I could do... The chin's a little bit weird, so I'm going to just do the chin a little bit better. Now that I'm actually close. But my, like... What's it called? My fatal flaw is that I draw from afar. Sometimes. I don't draw up close. Really dumb. I pick a spot really far. Not really far back, but really zoomed out. I'm just like, yeah, this'll do. There we go. Slightly more rotted. Slightly more fetid. I wouldn't be surprised if something like this showed up in the comic. It's super cool. It's such a cool concept. I'm really appreciative that this was Redeem. Super cool. It's like such a cool concept. And a nice combination of two very like awesome bits of folklore, which is something I adore. I adore folklore. Twitch moderators. It's the end of a sword, I swear. I swears. Always like the concern, isn't it? It's like, please. Not inappropriate. I swear. Addicted to drawing swords. Or just like rusted messes of. Have any of you guys seen that, there's an artist that I've seen on, like, Instagram Reels and stuff who does, like, folklore art does inkblot folklore art, and it's gorgeous. And he tells, like, the story of the creature. I'm a big fan of his work. It's so fascinating. But he like explains just like where these creatures came from in whatever folklore they had and his like intrigue and interest in their existence. Because one I recently watched was his illustration of Cthulhu, and it was beautiful. It was like absolutely beautiful, and he was talking about how much he adored that Cthulhu is more described by what it isn't, as opposed to what it is. Like, in first appearance of Cthulhu, in Call of Cthulhu, the creature is described by what it isn't more so than what it is. I find that deeply fascinating, because it's such a, like, it's not a description that's intended to be helpful, but it is visceral and emotive, if anything. I find really impressive. With that said, I feel like maybe I've put time into this. Certainly not been time wasted. Like, that's super cool. Because I love that, like, you know, from the right, it's really disturbing. This is a headless horseman who's head is like the pommel of a sword that's been pushed through him, but then on the left is just a horse head. But it's like a fake stuffed horse head, which is also like a thing that I really love drawing, is like stuffed like plush things. So I said I was done but I'm gonna just add some like fluff, the neck hole and the head hole and stuff like that. Old precious. Yeah. I need to fix anything. I mean, I'm sure I do, but like. Oh, he doesn't have a tail. That's terrible. That's terrible. That's just not the right. That's shite too. Sorry. Apologize profusely. That's terrible. That ain't no horse tail. Drawing two just really shitty horse tails, and I'm like, nah, I'm not happy with that. Do over. Try again. I might just cross out a little bit. Such a good prompt. Thank you for this one. Really good. Fan. Big fan of the prompt. Super cool. I'll throw in some guidelines. I could turn this into a tarot. I could put more effort into this. Like, I could come back to this later and then make it a tarot card. Super cool. Hey, oh, very sweet. Very sweet of you, Milky. In the name. The name of the card is Control. That's good. That's a good name. Thank you for entertaining my random thoughts. Ah, it's a pleasure. It's what I do. It's what we as artists do. Just throwing in like the most simplistic background, like matching, just so that it's like got a bit of visual. Just chuck it into the warm-up space. There we go. We'll reset. Yes, it will. That's so cool. I might do like a full-on version of that. I'd be curious to see where it goes. Now back to my week. Back to my this work. Throwing very generic looking bottles before I move on to shading and stuff. Ink bottle. That's not the right one. There we go. Doing it from really far away, just so that I could get everything correct before I get close and actually mess it up, or potentially mess it up. That one's not gonna matter, that one's not gonna matter. None of them gonna matter other than these ones. Literally all. We're a little close together, but that's fine. I can fix it. I can fix it because they're also just too dang large. Sorry, but you're just too dang loud. Bottle generic. Oh, that's how we roll. Oh, right. Oh, my brain ain't braining. Hold on. Do that. It'll make sense in a second, don't worry. I promise you it'll make sense in a second. Don't worry. Stretch. Ugh. I'll do that. For you. I will do that for you. Stretch out me back. I'm good. Just gonna reset, I think. It won't make sense now. Was gonna make sense, doesn't make sense now. I'm gonna fix it and restart. Got the wrong size and therefore also the color. Squiffy. Orange. That's too hot. Okay, perfect.
Yaha!
Did
Yaha!
it. That's orange and brown bottle. so it'll be just visible next to Ratchet's ear. Let's do that, and then I just fill it in later. It's okay. Zoom in. The minute alterations I gotta make is that I fill in these little spaces that did have color, or that were filled in by, bottles with just the color that it's supposed to be. I'm sure there's an easier way of doing this, but fuck it. Doesn't matter. Now we move on to shadows. This is the thing that I was just like, do I ever let things be easy on myself? No, never, because I'm gonna actually put a greater emphasis on shadows now that the flat color section is so simple. It's like so much more simplified. And that is basically, I actually gonna return to like color tone shadows, which I did when I started making the comic and compromised on and changed later. Because it took too much time and things like that. But yeah. Not anymore. Putting time and effort into this bad boy because it's gonna be my life's work. I have to spend that time. A handsome man this mucker is. Now for Twitch moderators, just so that you know, mucker is a old English term which means someone who used to dig gutters and things like that, or a hard working sort individual. It's not rude. Not a rude term. Please do not ban me. The usual groveling to Twitch every so often. Haven't been banned yet, but it's probably because of that groveling. I like to believe so, anyway. Just tears in my eyes as I beg them not to ban me, and they're just like, you're not a problem, Grey Mouse. We are not worried about you. Like, you're not wholesome, but, like, you've not done anything terrible. So I'm like, oh, sweet. Good. Golden. My goodness, what a handsome man this fellow is. I was joking about this in Monistera's stream that I keep drawing handsome men. I have just an issue that I just keep drawing handsome gentlemen. But you can tell by the way I'm, like, you can tell by my art what kind of thing I'm interested in. Like, handsome man. A couple of handsome dudes. I am fallible, you know, fallible. Just missed. There we go. Yeah. There we go. does pay off to just put a little bit more effort into shadows and stuff. Just because it ends up looking great. That's exactly what I need. Nice looking faces. Yeah, all I want, handsome face. Want all characters. Shadows, flat colors, because I've noticed an inkling problem. A few little issues, but that's okay. That was expected. The new coloring, like flat coloring style, not going to be perfect, but it's way better than just filling in. Like painter style, like painting in colors, it just takes too long. Doesn't make sense. Okay. Locally. That feels erased. Some of the line work is a little bit rough. But that's cool things that I can fix. Can fix, will fix. And I like a nice warm shadow. Just looks nice, you know? It's a sucker for a nice warm shadow. The shadow, because it's not gonna, definitely not gonna be illuminated, that's for sure. And I know some people use the lasso tool for, like, the shadows and stuff. I kind of like the control that I have over just painting. At least for now. There's a way of doing it faster and better, then I'll probably move on. It's all about learning. It's a learning process for me because I'm so... Like, I've been drawing for years, but I still feel so new to it. Maybe give it just a little in, more in, you know what I mean? It's more in. Does that make sense? No. More in. Just give him a little bit more in. No, just like move the shadows a little bit further in. That's what I mean. When I say give it more in. If anyone can remind me, just someone remind me to make a second paper bag for this panel, just so that I can lower the transparency on it and make it look like the bag is being like flipped. If you guys don't remember, I won't. I sure as frick won't. That's for sure. I don't forget to add second paper bag. Not now. Cryo. No. Now I'm definitely gonna forget. Cursed me. I'm doing yum best. You're right, you are. I can't fault you for that. You tried. You did do what I asked you to, essentially. My instructions were unclear. Weren't clear enough. No! Should have known that was going to happen too. Should have known, and yet I didn't. Completely unaware. Caught off guard by my own petard. And then that. Nice little rond bag. It'll... shadows, right? Already I so much prefer the colored shadows and lines and stuff. It just feels more to it. No, there's better, nicer texture as if no a nicer nicer look to it. Cool. It always makes me happy. Always happy to be wrong about stuff like that. It makes the look nicer, then makes it look nicer. Yeah, nice. Before I leave, just make sure. I fill in, oh geez. I fill in the eyes. And I just jump to a cold. Bababooey. Yes, make sure the eyes are good. Good and shaded. Before I leave. Fill in the RGs. Oh no. Yeah. There we go. Then we've got... Oh, hold on. Almost forgot his little shadows beneath his mustache. Mistake. There we go. A little bit beneath the lip, or beneath. And we are good. Shadows done. Maka. For now, I will return to do the shadows for the little paper bag. The next paper bag. Till then, don't matter. Now Ratchet's going to be a little bit complicated. Or a little bit more complicated. So I use a warm tone on his... clothing with a warm tone to it, but his skin color is going to need a different shadow tone because it's naturally cold. It's a green, like this light green is a naturally cold tone. I'm going to need something a little bit more complementary to it while still being potentially warm. I might take some time to figure that out. So have a kind of basic idea of what it should be, but I don't necessarily want to go just teal. That just won't be the right look. Right, shading. But yeah, as I get like a colder color, I need to kind of accommodate for it. Shading. I wouldn't want to just throw it like, look at that. It's just green. Comes out green, shaded. So I gotta just be a little bit more intentional, careful about how that colored. But the yellows of his eyes can get a nice warm color. Gotta remember to line it up when I work through cold or the colder color. Out this. Fill in. I'll probably fill in the background. Trick that Sunny taught me. The majority of it. that. But makes my life easier, and I love making my own life easier. Yes, that's right. Zoom in to make sure it did the job. Yes, it did. For the most part, it did. Awesome. And then we fill in the bits that either are too hard to get with that, or just require a little bit more that independent, like, not independent, but like that more paintery kind of look that I'm going for. Just realizing that maybe I don't want to go all the way through with that. Yeah, because it's not all shaded. Hey, Orpa, how you doing? Hello. How you doing? Just going back on something that I said. Just fixing it up, basically, because I don't want all of this to be in shadow. I actually do want the just basic, essentially. So just that and redo it. Seems we've got colors in. Yes, I've been taught a really useful trick on how to do colors. And it's changed my life. But yeah, as a result, I now don't need to put quite so much like pain taking effort into the colors. Great. I can kind of zip through stuff and remain true to my promise that I was going to get chapter 2 done before the end of the year. And so far we are very much on track, which is so cool. Like genuinely so cool. I'm so close, like genuinely so close to actually making that a reality. Or I can get chapter 2 done out, and then I can enjoy my Christmas break knowing that people can read the comic, or can read a little bit of the comic while they're waiting for the next chapter. It's great. Thanks. Yeah, I'm very excited to actually get this chapter released. It's a little bit of just like world building stuff, but it's still, you know, important. Important to the comic. Oh, Arnie's cute little Tengu. Yeah, I appreciate the support. Getting so close. So exciting. Like, all the draft work is done. Now all that's left is for me to actually do it. Actually fill in the colors and all the things. Very exciting. A little nerve-wracking, but very exciting. It's always a little nerve-wracking at the end, like as we get close to the end of a chapter. Because it's like, oh, am I going to get this done in the timeline I want? Are people going to mind that it's not maybe not quite as much action? Well, the previous chapter didn't have a whole lot of action, so I'm not super worried about it there. Even so. sure people are excited to see it like ramp up and escalate. But it is also only chapter 2, so I'm sure I'm just overthinking it. But yeah, right now I'm just excited. Just excited to get another chapter out. Thinking about it now, I also think my streamiversary has, like, long passed. It's like, when did I start streaming? Oh yeah, probably long before. Long before now. I'm just like, ah, who cares? Don't matter, none. Not gonna sell. I wasn't really gonna celebrate it anyway. But I was just like, I've been doing this for a year now. So wild to think about. Right. Now what's next? Might fill this wall. Shadow. But other than that, just need to fill the old thing. Old colours. Congrats for your first year and for many more to come. Ah, thank you all. That's very sweet of you to say. I've had a very wholesome time this stream. I got Milky jumping in like straight up and she was just, they were just like super sweet. And so that was really uplifting. That's always like, that's what makes it so much easier is that I've got such an amazing, like, I've been surrounded by such amazing people who are just so supportive. And I think, like, genuinely, if I hadn't had such a supportive start, I probably wouldn't be quite as committed or as motivated. Ah, you super sweet streamer, get a super sweet community. Very hugely in terms of my wholesomeness. I am flattered and chuffed. Look at the mirror to blame that. Aye. Sweet, you're too kind. Kind. Ugh, that's flat colours. That's why it looked so horrible. Ugh. There we go. Yeah. Blue for that is great. But yeah, I don't think I'd be nearly as far as I am without the support, and the amount of support as well has been not overwhelmingly, but incredibly positive. I've only had like a small handful of negative encounters or situations surrounding my streaming and stuff, and it's all been fairly easy to ignore just because I know that like the vast majority of people who watch my stuff are wonderful. But yeah. Always an awareness that I have that I know that I'm getting super wholesome. At points, I'm like, oh, there's always the rotten eggs in a huge amount of people like Twitch. Yeah, exactly. Such a vast population of people. There are always going to be just people who are just there to be nasty and make things more difficult for other people who are just trying to entertain or spread joy or do, you know, whatever. Or just, you know, even for the people who are just trying to, like, make money, it's like even those people don't really deserve to be annoyed, like, treated the way that these trolls do, but, like, they're trolls, and that's what they do. Yeah, you always get some trolls. Yeah, exactly. It's par for the course. I'm immensely privileged that, like, I've never really had to deal with them too much, which has been awesome. Got my small situations, but other than that, it's been very easy to, like, be chill and stuff. I troll respectfully with love. Yeah, exactly. And it's like, the people that I do get on here who troll regularly are very, like... Like, I love a bit of banter, and they understand, like, the boundaries and stuff, so I've never had big situations where it's unbearable, or I've had to, like, set ground rules or anything like that. That's in your mod contract. Yeah, exactly. Oh, wait. I may have been mod for a while. Yeah, you've been mod for a little while. So I didn't tell you, but I made you mod at some point. More recently, like, it's not... It's been in the past few months, but I made you a mod because I think I always intended for you to be a mod, but I just never got around to it. Anyway, I appreciate that. You're very welcome. The thing was, because I was always going to make you a guard, like, you're a guard of Timberstone. So I was like, you should probably be a mod, because I can't just make you a guard of Timberstone unless you're a mod, because that was, like, one of my rules. That's some dangerous game. I'm sure it'll be fine. It'll be okay. But yeah, all my mods are guards in the comic. And I was like, you're going to be a guard. So you've got to be a mod. Got to be a mod or something. I made you a mod of my Twitch. You're a guard. Yeah, you're a guard. You're a guard in the comic. That's how many streamers do it. Just silently add it. Then you go to a stream and they're like, huh, what's this? I was tricked. Yes, welcome to the roles and responsibilities. You like watching the streamer? Well, guess what? You've now been given a job. Yeah, you're a guard, and I'll show you. So all the draft work for Chapter 2 is done, but it also introduces the guard's armor for the Timberstone, like, guard. So we actually get the first introduction of the guard. And so this is their guard's armor, which I based partially off of, like, a salt and pepper shaker with the eyes. The Disco Elysium, like, revolutionary's armor. And then I also added a Conquistador's helmet. So that's, like, the base helmet set. And all my guards have them. So, yeah, you're very welcome. And now you can't give it back or the streamer gets offended. Exactly, you can't revoke mod. You have to just continue to be mod. Just deal with it. I'm only a mod in one other, like, stream, and I already don't like the pressure, but y'all have to. Have to deal with it now. Part of the Grey Mass stream. Part of the Grey Mass stream team. So, deal with it. That being said, also a thing that I need to add to, like, the T's and C's or terms and conditions. I can't believe I explained T's and C's. To the T's and C's of being a mod is that you can't really add character designs because you're getting your own character implemented anyway. You're allowed to make requests and stuff. That's still totally okay. But the character design stuff is for the community other than the mods, just because the mods get their own characters and additional accoutrement to their, like, characters. Even my little character is a meme. It's the Pacha meme. Oh, that's cute. Yeah. I was watching Emperor's New Groove recently as well. Yeah. That's it. I'm a big fan of your emotes. They're very cool. And very funny. All your inappropriate ones. I say as if I don't have inappropriate emotes. I would never say, like, oh, add this guy with a sword and a dagger without being mostly a joke. Yeah, that's totally fair. So the accommodation I make for it is that, like, so Loki has told me about the stuff that he'd, like, added. I got many inappropriate emotes. Oh, yes, you do. They're fantastic. Loki's guard is going to have a little sausage dog called Mitzi. And that's Loki's puppy who passed away recently. I'm more than happy to add and include stuff like that. I think Lumen and Sal, I'll probably give them Ted. Things like, oh, speaking of, how did that work? I literally, that was the first time I said your name in this stream and you appear. I also said Ted and you just appeared. We love the Giant Goose. The Giant Goose is fantastic. Call for the Devil and she has appeared. Amazing. How did that work? I was just explaining like the guards, like the guard additions and stuff. So guards get like my mods and stuff, they'll get a few little things added to their guard like character in the comic. I was just saying you and Lumen will probably have Ted. I'll add Ted to the comic world because why not? It's a me, Sal. It's a you, Sal. But yeah, and that's like the kind of allowance I'm giving because I'm kind of revoking your allowance for character designs. And another thing was that like my friends who are characters in the D&D campaign that this is based on, they don't get to add character designs because their actual characters are in this comic. So they don't get that. They actually get like characters with spoken line bits. Fuck them. They already get too much. Just saying all this stuff as if I'm fully expecting Nex to appear. Now, I'm summoning Nex. Don't mind me. But yeah, so Nex has a character in the comic who actually has, like, lines and stuff. Because she had a character in the campaign. But she doesn't get to add character design. Fuck that. And even though she's a mod, she also doesn't get a guard. Just fuck that. Is this some summon circle now? Yeah, I just summon all my favorite people. Started with Cryo and Sal. I'm manifesting Lumen. Manifesting Lube Man. My current favorite joke, just saying Lube Man is instead of Lumen. But yeah. While I summon Nex, I'm just manifesting Lumen. And then also, I'll manifest Frosty as well. Frosty's great. He's going to be a guard too. All my mods are guards. And that also includes all the moderators for Discord. Because I think I've only got one difference there. Where I've got one moderator for Discord who isn't a mod here. But he gets to be a moderator. He gets to be a guard, not a moderator. He gets to be a guard. That's what I meant to say. But yeah, also because it gives me plenty of like stuff to fill out, you know, story and world-wise. I've told Giggles about it already. I've told her that she is a town guard. And she doesn't know how to respond, which is always good. Always a good sign. A moderator who gets to be a moderator. Generous. Yeah, exactly. I make you a moderator, so then you're a moderator, you know? You get how that works, you know. It's the use. The use. Comes with the usual roles and responsibilities. Being a moderator, except you're a moderator, you know how it is. Somebody said my name 2.5 times and I appear. Yeah! I manifested him. He's here. The Lubeman. Hello. I was just explaining mod rules. How you all get to be city city town guards. If you're a mod, you're a guard. If you're not a mod, you can add character designs into the character design sheet. If you played in the D&D campaign that this is based off of, you get nothing. You're already a character. Your nose is bleeding. Oh no! La 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 lube and. La 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 lube and. Lloyd. There are two L's. It's La Lloyd. La Lumen. The Dederic. Eric. Name is Creo. Brain pulling a sneaky on me. Hurting my thoughts. My brain. There you go. Sorry, it's a side effect of the summon mouse used. We hope to get rid of it in the future. It's a rudimentary demon summon, of course, but it works. As we can see, it definitely works. Got your Wacom out too? Let's compare the size of our Wacoms. Yeah! Pick up my Wacom, you just hear it like clunking about. I have the 15 inch. Sorry, not sorry for making you sick, Creo. Told you I wasn't interested in patching with you. Should have done now, because it's like you would have gotten sick all the same. That's the mistake. Unless you did and then just got sick because, which is pretty bad. I have the same Wacom. I bought mine after I saw you stream. Oh yeah, I remember that. Oh, 15 inch. That's a big one. That's a big one. Pretty big. It's pretty big. Pretty happy with it. You know, can't complain. There's a 22 inch one and that scares the shit out of me. Like, how do people use something like that without like losing blood? Brain cells. No, it's like, so, I'm trying my best to make it not innuendo, but it's so big. Can't even imagine using something like that. Like, can't avoid the innuendo. But yeah, it's wild. I'm happy with my size. Yes, we do both have Wacoms out of aspiration. Yeah. Love to hear it. I love tricking people into buying really expensive drawing equipment and also inspiring them to draw. If I can do that, I'm happy mouse. Get drawing, people. Do nothing else with your life. Learn to draw. Cool. What is the average girth of a Wacom? Depends on what Wacom you get. I would say, very secretly, a Wacom sales mouse. I would love to be a sales mouse for Wacom. Holy shit, they've sent me cease and desist letters about the way I pronounce it. But I'd love to be a mouse for it, or a sales mouse. Well, tell me your girth. 15 inch. It's the 16, but it's 15 inch, because I don't know. I don't know how they came up with that. It's the Wacom Cintiq 16, but it's 15 inches. And to me, that's silly, because it should be the 15. 15. Both 15 by 15. Yeah, I don't have a ruler. The girth is 15 inches. The height is 11? No. Measurement of a screen is usually diagonal. Oh, right. You're right. I don't know. That's a maths question. And we all know I don't do maths. I'm Grey Mouse, not Grey Maths. I pot and use this, throw a triangle at me, I'm like, book. And we're on to highlights. Throws a pizza. No! Well, A to B times two, B to A2 times B2 equals C2. It's getting flashbacks to when I was a kid crying. I couldn't solve a maths problem. Being sad and stuff. You're using letters in your maths. That's cheating. Yeah, that's not maths. This isn't literature. I thought this was maths. Mathematics. Or red. Right. Maybe too much red. Not enough red. Not enough. Little symbols, guys. We don't do symbols here. Just what's it called? Summoning. Satanic summoning. Damned math teacher's always asking me to find my ex. She gone. Leave her alone. Stop reminding me. No, tears. Just tears. Reminded. Just remembering all those math classes I failed horrifically at. It'd be more confusing if it was two times. Oh my god, yeah. Oh my god. No maths. No maths in my. Dang, chat. Get that shit out of here. No maths. Get rid of it. Get that thing out. I don't know. I'm terrible at maths. So bad at maths, I've not even been taking it in. That's how bad I am at it. Of 12 are going to bounce out to prep your stream. Have a good one, guys. Good one, Loom. Have a good stream if I'm not in there. If I'm not in there after my stream. So if that symbol is 12. That's terrible. Then plus equals 24. But I can't remember what squared does. It squares it. Makes it a square, not a cube, because that's three-dimensional. Goes to two-dimensional. That's not right. Kind of does need that extra nostril. Other nostril. That's not the right. There we go. There we go. Right. So it makes it, oh my god, being 48. Oh, nice, cool. Oh, that's the girth. Yeah, that makes sense. That's almost exactly how it goes when I was in maths, when I used to do maths. I was like, yeah, that sounds about right. No, that's not correct. Oh shit. Oh no. To square something, you would X. Oh, this is the find my ex part, isn't it? There we go. I'm actually putting a little bit more detail into the highlights and stuff. Putting a bit more reds and Making it 144 rather. If 2 equals 144, if 12. Sheer shock on my face. Right. This is clear and concise math. Maths. Keep up, mouse. Is it not amazing that I could talk? Why are you making me study human maths? Human maths! No! I want out. I want off this planet. I mean, I ain't no mathematician, I'm a mouse. Love that just the end of that is just like, I'm no mathematician, I'm a mouse, and that's it. There's no, like, expansion of that. Sometimes I am impressed by how much I can achieve without maths, because my brain just don't do it. My brain just don't compute it. Sometimes I have to pull out my fingies, stare at them, and be like, yep, counting simple numbers. This is a simple number. And then my brain's like, I don't believe you. Not clean shaven too. I need to. Some stubble on his face. So width 2 plus height 2 equals diagonal 2. Oh man. I didn't learn maths when I had to. I ain't learning it now when I dis not have to. I almost said dis have to. How does facial hair work? I actually use Pythagoras basically every day for your work. Oh man, shit. Good on ya. That is actually impressive. Someone who is critically bad at math, that is actually very impressive. Because I just don't got the brain for it. My brain just don't work that way, you know? And like, critically doesn't work that way. I did really badly on my last maths test ever, and my teacher's like, we need to get you out of this class. Otherwise, like, flipping burgers at McDonald's is going to be too good for you. You're not going to have, like, the score you need to just study at a university level, even though you are capable of that. That was basically it. I was smuggled out of maths my final year because I was so bad at it. Damn, what a handsome man. I was fairly good at math in school, but I'm horrible at patterns and sequence. That's fair. With how your, like, your brain takes in information and doesn't, like, because you don't, like, you don't have that voice in your head. I guess that would make sense. If I remember what you've told me correctly, I'm not just making assumptions about you. Everyone in the audience, I'm not just assuming stuff about Cryo. No visuals or voice. Yeah. We're not just bullying Cryo, everybody. There is... He's told me this story before, and I remember it because he's my friend. That being said, those who know me know I love to bully. Love a good bully. I'm not... This isn't... Yeah. It's a rare occasion where I'm actually being just aware. Damn, what a handsome man. Speaking of aware. Aware of how handsome this man is. Probably. He's not bullying me when he says, my head is empty, probably. Well, it's full of like, brain juice stuff, that's for sure. Full of, Jesus Christ. It's full of Pythagorean theorems. Or just the one, just done, like, done over and over again, but not visualized. Washy goopy brain juice. Yes. The great equalizer. No matter how you visualize information or take in knowledge, we all, at the end of the day, cracked our heads open, we'd have that sloshy brain goop. Sweet, sticky, sloshy brain goose. Bruce juice. Okay, if you crack open an egg, egg innards. No matter what kind of egg it looks like. Or how that egg visualizes patterns or mathematics. Everybody got some grey mouster in their noggin. Exactly. Like the movie Ratatouille, except the grey mouse in your brain is a chemical. Not a whimsical little rat that teaches you to cook or draw, depending on what kind of mouse you get. Yeah, not a blue rat. Yeah, exactly. But on the bright side, you're not disobeying any health codes by having it in your head. A grey mouse. A blue rat who can visualize flavor. Yes, that's true. He can, can't he? A weird little mouse. I mean, rat. What a strange fellow that Remy was. Hey, he knew how to cook. Oh, Lumen and Zephy just started their co-stream. Oh, yeah! Make sure I raid into them once I'm done, I think. Cause that'll be a good stream. Everybody. Don't leave the stream, just open up another tab and go check it out because it's going to be awesome. Oh, jeez. I'll be back, I'll go get my boy into bed. Fair enough. You do what you gotta do. In a bit. Highlights are going to take slightly longer. That's totally okay. More than happy to have them take a little longer. We got time. Out of place, but that's fine. Slowly been continuing to try and educate myself on art and stuff, so I've been watching a lot of syntax draws. Their name, I don't know how to pronounce it properly, but their work is gorgeous and amazing. So I'm just slowly trying to learn from them. But a lot of my stuff now is slowly taking like different forms and things like that, which is super important. Because I want to get to a point where I'm not worried about making something look right. Get what I mean? You know, like that's a secondary thought. Like it's like my goal is to be like, I know how to draw bodily anatomy perfectly, so I can switch it up how I need to. And do it, you know, properly or wrong. Intentionally, opposed to being like, oh, I'm struggling to make this look human. Working on that, working at it. Gonna take a while, but I'm okay. You know, take that time. I have that time. By the very last page, very last panel, very last comic that I work on, for this comic, you'll be able to see just like a significant visual difference. That's what I'm super excited about, because that's going to be insane. Like looking at back on where I started compared to where I finish, going to be huge. Not just artistically as well, but like my life as well. And that's going to be different. It's going to take ages, so it's going to have to be hugely different. I'm excited. Well, those things, the future, what's it going to hold? And I can only be excited about that. Fine. Maybe not what I'm going for. Bit softer. Softer and more subtle. Yeah, that'll do. Before I move off of Maka's design, I'm just gonna do something. Pupils. Right now. This is something I learned directly from the video I was watching today. Yeah, just a little bit of orange. The eye, start filling it in. And it looks like, remember, it's like a type of Pokemon. Smiley was here, they'd be able to tell me. But the Pokemon that has this kind of color palette. Trying it. See them. Much, much messier than I intended. Okay. And actually, highlight brush. Actually using the highlight brush for what I intended for. One point. Find. Going off of it. But okay. That's okay. Lightest bit of lighting apron. Big, nothing special. Enough. Gonna move ratchet. They're the most important, like the biggest and most detailed parts. Fill in the other space later. Change the way I do hair highlights, because the way I did it before was just too much. Just too much. Too much going on, didn't make a lot of sense. Just keep it simple. Come to learn, just keep it make sweet little faces. Like this grumpy little face here. Do one little, or try something like. So basically, if you shine a torch into someone's ear, thin layers of skin around it will glow red. One thing I want to try. Oh, hold on. Is actually adding that. Is. Then highlights, color spray, that's fucking big color spray. Hey mouse, hey moose. Hello Creo. How is ya? Don't forget the extra paper bag or something. I mean, good, always good to remind me actually. Thanks for that. Don't forget the extra paper bag. And ratchet just a little bit of like red. That, nah, that looks a little off. Yellow though kind of looks, I mean, it does look nice. Because like light passing through the ears makes sense. Especially ratchet's ears because they're very thin. Or they're big. They're quite big and they're quite thin. Yeah. I like that. I like that a little bit more. Paper bag, not yet ready for the paper bag. Getting there though. Getting close. That's the last thing I do before I move on from this. Bag. doing a little bit more for the eyes, just darkening ever so slightly. Not so much in a, like, not ideally so much in a shadowing kind of way, but just in a, bring in fine, like, details and stuff. And a little. A little bit too bright. Best. Yeah, because I don't need highlights that are too obvious on the face. Keep them a little bit subtle. And I do love the little pastel kind of markings, Ratchet's eyes. It's them. Let it be. Yeah. Let that highlight thing. Make it shiny. Like, what I'm trying to avoid is making the, like, cloth and stuff shiny. Come across as shiny. I definitely don't want it to read as shiny. Whereas the metal stuff, I do. But same sort of idea or intention, that I don't want it to be shiny, so I give it just intentional aberrations, faults and stuff like that. There we go. It's nice and simple. Again, keeping it simple. Too much. This is almost like white. I had to find it. Is that looks terrible. That's it. Terrible line. There we go. Much better. Much better. What's last? Brown bits. And by little brown bits, I mean also these bits. Oh, wait, no, last thing I need to do is the second paper back. I've been telling my chat to pester me about, or just to tell, remind me. I have. Cryo has been reminded. The fact that I almost forgot is telling for me. Bag. Yeah. Get this. Second bag. There we go. That simple. It's not that simple, actually. Never mind. That simple. And then it's its own flat color. And then it doesn't need its own highlights, but it definitely needs its own shadow. But the cool thing about it is that I actually don't need a shadow layer for it because I have the color for it. I have the shadow color that it will look like on the bag itself. Yeah. Just fill it in as such. And I need to do the light layer, so it's actually not even close to being fully done. But add a few motion lines, that's wiggly. Edge. Yes, they can. All right, and then next, add the light layer. Just going through the motions. Do I need to do more of that? No, that's pretty good. I think that's okay. Yeah, I'm okay with that. very happy with that, how that face has turned out. Is everything. Say again, as it. Add more. Little middle fingers. Little surprise. Yeah. I'm pretty sure there are speech bubbles here. There are! Fine, I'll add them in later. When I don't need them. Two hours, I've done one panel. That's not terrible. That's good. I feel like I'm going to be able to do one more I don't want to say I can finish the whole page in 1 hour. I think that's maybe aspirational. But I feel like I could get this one. At least one more done, for sure. So I really want to get onto the next page, because the next page is, like, I've put so much detail into the draft that it's going to look awesome. Like, it's going to be so cool, and so cool to work on as well. Just keep filling in space, even if the panel is just bigger than the draft originally started from. Just keep it moving, keep it going, keep the space filled. That's all that matters. Almost. That one will do. That one's bad. Light. I can probably outline that line with shading. It's going to be weird how to draw Ratchet's eye from the side, because that front-on version isn't right. That looks creepy as shit. Not doing that. Not to my boy. Maybe you should be like have a happier expression. He's not a serious character. I mean, fix it if I need to. And it from quite so big, quite so Jimmy Neutron-esque. Want to avoid that kind of a look. Maybe his eye is just like a little too arched. It looks like he's almost tired. Doesn't give the right impression. Character. That's maybe too awake. It looks angry just because of this little bit of eyebrow. Well, not eyebrow, but like little eyepiece. Very. Probably what will like lead me to okay, that's pretty good. Go give him his arm because he is leaning against the counter, so he may as well fill that in properly. Now, what I'm looking to do. Quick as anything. That happened. Oh, that's why. No way. Oh, no, never mind. I don't know why. Oh, wait, no, I do. I'm not expand just by 2. That's not what I wanted to do. Wrong color. There we go. Perfect. Everything that has been selected. Oh wait, no, this. The one thing I dislike about this is that gotta fill in. This stuff, otherwise it filled in with the paintbrush tool. It's a pain in the ass. I did it again. Clicked the wrong thing. Need to go to line work, then magic wand tool. Oh, it's his, not his shoulder, it's his, scarf. Oops. Not correct there. Okay. Pull it all in a second. Not my. Hand it out, fill it in. Got a line work. Select it, expand it. Pick a new color, fill it in. There we go. In. Pick a new color, set of flat colors, rinse and repeat. Color, this color, that pick. Go to flat colors. Back to line work. Again, rinse and repeat. Also, hit shift. Extra. Extra. Okay, what's left? Just the back wall. Something like that. But I'm just gonna throw shadows into this space just because. Makes sense. Time on that. It'll be too much work. But very little reward, because it's like, I love doing high detail, but that amount of detail for such a small panel, which a good majority of it will be covered over, it's not worth it. Of time. Start with blue this time, just because that'll be a predominant color. Okay, buddy, gotta get my sick self to bed. No problem, cryo, get some sleep, get some rest. Gotta recover. Take care of yourself, man. See you around. I'll see you around too. See you around. Get some rest. Gonna work tomorrow. Oh god, that is rough. I'm so sorry. So sorry to hear that, man. That's so rough. Well, hopefully you feel way better tomorrow. Tip head. Ratchet. Not too far. Shadow. Little pupil makes it. Erase that. Get rid of that. That's not what we want. Panel should by the building. Little mini deadline. My actual real big. Wooey. Shadows fill with shadows. Then I need to make darker shadows. Going on out there. silhouette of a really detailed person, just like a blob. I have to put that much effort. Yeah. Care about me. What I would idealize possible. Yeah. Do highlights this. Feeling the tired. I will sleep well. Sure. Not too much light in this space, which I actually kind of like. It looks like super cool. Dots as it is like almost commas space, like little indent. I mean, this won't be a lot of work at all, really. Which is great, because I love, you know, big gain without a lot of risk or effort, not risk. I say as if I'm not making just a huge comic. Like, that massive amount of effort that goes into making a comic, I'm just like, oh yeah, that's like, that's par for the course, it's part of the job. But, I can cut a corner, like the little rat that I am, then I've won. Yeah, Ratchet's, like, eyes are a weird one. Aren't they? His pupils are huge. He doesn't really have anything outside of that, outside of his pupils. Like all the other characters, but he's still cute as fuck, so live with that. One thing I am going to do, just bip, there we go, and then light. Definitely not add. Is it not? Maybe it is, but just a little bit less. A little bit less of it. Oh, jeez. Probably could just load the opacity. Don't matter. I got a few things to add to the shadows, but lazy. But the portraits. I'm not doing the portraits again. Let's do a little, pull a little sneaky. Get it. Yeah, because it's also going to be unnoticeable. Done. Gonna be just a big speech bubble right here in the center. And last bit of light, just the hexagons that I love so much. Hexagon brush. That's not right. Doesn't need that much. Like that, just erase. Cut off. I always add these motion lines because I always feel like I don't have enough when I go into the viewing process. Erasing them as I say that, it's because they're not big enough. There we go. Oh, I don't have enough time to do the last three. Oh man, I could. I'm trying to convince myself, that's the thing. Now I'm just doing like, I am bargaining with myself about it. Can I do it? Last three, no, absolutely. Last, like, one of these. Maybe. I write in. And do set the line work up now. When I separate these layers, they will all have line work and flat colors. Makes my job just that little bit easier. Got 20 minutes. Do we think I could do one more thing? 20 minutes. I think so. It's a bag. It's a greasy bag. I think I could draw a greasy bag. 20 minutes. I think I can do it. As long as I don't go fancy with it. Fancy with it. Just keep it simple, Grey Mass. Bit simple. And keep it simple, mouse. Right, fill in line. Erase this one. A few details. Perfect. All right. That covers. Let's get this done as quickly as possible. Not anymore. Oh, wait. Why am I doing it that way? I'm stupid. Oh, man. As if I don't have a completely great system of how to fill this, like, fill in these colors. Will I ever learn? Bring it in by 2 pixels, band by 2 pixels. And these things are the exact same. So. Fill it in, and then I'll add soft like shadow behind it. Thing. Shadows. Multiply. Gray. A bit of color. And soft. Okay, cool. Shadows done. For the bag, anyway. But not for the bag, shadow. Bag needs a shadow. Of course. Makes perfect sense. The bag needs a shadow. It would cast a shadow, so the bag's shadow. The bag's shadows are done. The bag's shadow's shadow is not done. Okay, nice. Cool. Back. This way, because the other way isn't going to work unless I make a box around this line work. Fastest way. How much time do I have? I have 13 minutes. Alright, let's get this done. So close. So little. So, come on. Go. Yeah, beautiful. Highlights. Lovely little grease stains. There we go. And then just a bit of light. Whack. There we go. Did it. Achieved it. Achieved what we set out to achieve. Got one more panel. 10 minutes to spare. That's so good. Three panels in one stream with an additional warm-up. Done and dusted, that's some good. Alright. Just gonna quickly export. And we'll raid out. Never know, I may go back through. Fix up the paper bag, but that's another time. Now, where's my mouse? There it is. Mi cursor. All right. Wow, there's a lot of people streaming. I did say I wanted to raid into Lumen. And I might... Might as well. I promised. Right into lube, man. Oh, I just wrote lube, man. Lumen. Alright, we'll jump to lumen. And then... shall... head on out. Oh, that was a good amount of progress for the day. Like, I'm really happy with that. I think I'm getting almost overconfident about how I think we could probably get chapter 2 done before Christmas. But anyway, next time I see you guys, I'll be playing Dredge. So until then, I will see you guys later. Bye.